Nice weather. I love California weather. It's a perfect place for outdoor activities. The project I made this time is a local map that can be used for outdoor activities. This project is to put map data in advance and then use GPS information to display the map data on the screen without a Wi-Fi connection. It's like, if you prepare map data for your travel destination before going on a trip, you can display your location on the map without an internet connection at any time. It runs on battery, and as you can see here, since it uses e-paper, you can see the screen without reflection even during the daytime. And since it's e-paper that can express colors, you can check the map information more effectively. I personally prefer Raspberry 02W. If you need better performance, you can use Raspberry 4 or 5 or just Nano. They are very good SBC single board computers, but they consume too much power to run on batteries. For projects that have a slow performance but need to run a battery, I always use 02W. It can be configured to run the system all day with a battery pack. Let's see how I was able to complete this project. Please skip this part if you don't need to check how to start the Raspberry Pi. The first thing to do is, as you know, prepare the Raspberry Pi 0. I'm using a 64-bit Debian desktop OS. I need a network environment to do all the work on the console. Please make sure to enter the Wi-Fi information you want to connect to before installation so that you can start easily. After installation, when you connect the power, it will automatically connect to the Wi-Fi you set in advance. Since the Raspberry Pi is connected to the local network, you can easily connect via SSH. Now, update the Raspberry Pi as needed. This completes the preparation of the Raspberry Pi. It's time to test the GPS module. The GPS module I use is Reyax GNSS. Since data is transferred via UART, you only need to connect a 3.3 volts, ground, TX, and RX. Set up the Raspberry Pi interface. You can enable the serial port. This will allow you to connect the serial port on your Raspberry Pi. The Minicom is a serial communication program. You can check the information via the serial port through this. To simple check the information coming in via serial, you can check that the serial is being received using the cat command. Some data is continuously being received. The reason it appears as ASCII code is that a serial baud rate is not correct. You can easily check the serial information with the specific baud rate using the screen command. Finally, we can see the raw data that we normally see through the console when receiving GPS information. This allowed me to confirm the connection between the Raspberry Pi and the GPS module. Let me show you how I connect the e-paper to the Raspberry Pi. It's super easy. The e-paper used in this project is a Spectra 7.3-inch color e-paper. It's easy to connect because there is a head for Raspberry Pi. So this display is connected to the head and has a SPI full wire connection from the head to the Raspberry Pi. This completes the connection between the Raspberry Pi and the e-paper. It's that easy. Since this connects via SPI, we need to enable this interface. After that, if you install the Python library to use this display as instructed, you can use it very easily. Then, if we run the example Python code, you can see that the ePaper is working. This confirms that there is no issue with the connection between the ePaper and the Raspberry Pi. We have confirmed that Raspberry Pi's GPS module and ePaper are all working. It's time to make the mounting plate. I bought this wooden board for crafting from Daiso. This is highly recommended for DIY projects. It's very easy to use for light projects that are not too heavy. There's nothing special about this assembly. I'm going to place the ePaper and GPS module on the front of this board, and the Raspberry Pi and battery pack on the back side. This is the device I made for this project. It doesn't look bad. Anyway, in the next video, I will cover how to prepare a local map file and how to use it. See you soon.